Hey guys, what's going on? It's Max. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. But today, what I'm bringing you guys is a chem strike on the map Prison Break from a very good friend of mine. You guys have seen him a couple times on my channel. Tempted Swift, aka David, was very nice to give me this gameplay because let's not lie to each other. I hate the game Ghost and I really don't play it as much. I do play a lot more Battlefield. I'm hoping to bring some more Battlefield to you guys because it's fun and I enjoy having fun. But today, let's cut all of the crap out. Today, what I want to talk about is the recent YouTube drama. Things have been going down behind the scenes with copyrights. Apparently, YouTube and the companies around them have been cracking down really hard on gameplay, especially, and to who owns the rights to certain videos on YouTube. And I'm pretty sure this has been happening for everybody, not just the gaming community, but because I am very closely tied with the gaming community, it becomes part of my everyday life to look at all of the nasty, stupid shit that people put on Twitter and to kind of just speculate on it. Normally, I don't do this, and I'm going to let you guys know right now that this might turn into a rant, but I'm going to try to keep this very, very objective. Recently, everyone's been saying, well, gaming is dying on YouTube. They're not allowing us to maintain our ad revenue, blah, 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 on our videos. What are they doing? Bigger YouTubers, people who have more than, you know, 100,000, 200,000, upwards of a million subscribers are complaining about the fact that their channels are getting hit with copyright claims left and right. And the problem with channels like that is that they have videos pretty much over 1,000 videos, which means they could get anywhere between 100 to 200, even to 300 or 400 copyright claims on their videos, simply due to the fact that some company or maybe some generalized copyright shenanigans came down and kind of just claimed their videos. But my whole thing behind this is that people are overreacting. I mean, literally to the point where they think that someone is committing murder on their videos, and I don't understand why. And I went on Twitter and I wanted to ask the bigger YouTubers and even the smaller ones as to how far this copyright issue is really affecting their channels. And so far, we've only dove into like the first couple days of this happening, and I've noticed that some channels, my channel has not been hit with a copyright strike, which I'm very grateful for. But if it does, I do have the opportunity to dispute said copyright claim on my video, as does everyone. Every single person on YouTube has the right to dispute such copyright claims on their videos. So the problem that I'm having is that people are just sitting down and complaining, saying that, oh, my life's work is going down the toilet. This is what I do for a living. Oh, I won't be able to make another YouTube video again. And I'm sitting here like, no, stop. Pipe the fuck down and pay attention to what you have to do. Everything that goes to YouTube has some sort of legal loophole that you can get through, or some sort of way of getting the things or getting the necessary outcome that you really need, aka a dispute. Okay, so when people go to dispute said copyright stuff, I have yet to see someone who has lost a massive, I mean massive amount of videos on YouTube. So I think it's really ludicrous that you see these bigger YouTubers saying, oh, well, you know, my channel's going to the shitter because they brought all of these claims out, and I'm sitting here like, whoa, 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 whoa. You've got over 1,000 videos on your channel, and maybe 20 of them have a copyright strike. 20 videos out of 1,000. I don't think those 20 videos, unless they're music parodies, unless those are the most viewed videos on your channel, will actually affect you. And this goes for people who own Let's Play channels, because they're going to be hurt the most severely out of this. For others who just do stream highlights and commentaries and stuff, you might not be affected that much. Let's face the facts. And that's just due to people having to get stuff done. Now, I've seen the bigger channels say, like, 100 of my videos, 200 of my videos have been hit with copyright claims. And I've gone through and I've waited to see, oh, well, 200 of my videos got hit with a copyright claim, but they got taken off the internet. That's not the case. The case is the fact that they get hit with a copyright claim and now they have to dispute it. So, essentially, the only thing that they're complaining about is the fact that they have to actually dispute the copyright claim. So you're complaining about the fact that you have to spend time defending the videos that you put on the internet. Why? It blows my mind. If you cared, if you truly cared about your content over the fact that it's not making you money, then you would fight tooth and nail for every single video that you put on the internet. everything. Even if it's something so dumb with you sitting in a chair saying fluffy bunny for 30 seconds, you would fight for that video. Why? Because you love what you do. You love the videos that you put up. But all I'm hearing about this is, oh my God, I'm not going to be able to make any money. The money should be the afterthought. If this is something you're so passionate about, you love making videos, then getting your content back should be the first and foremost thing. Why? Ask me why. I know that you make a living on YouTube, but ask me why getting your videos back is the most important thing. Because it has defined you as a person. It has defined you as who you are in this community, who you are as an entertainer. Those videos hold the very secrets that unlock what makes you entertaining, what brings people to your channel. And without that, you're nothing. It doesn't matter if that video doesn't make money anymore. If people can't come to see you for you, if people can't come to watch your videos for you, if people can't come for some sort of entertainment like they came to YouTube for, what is the purpose of having a video? So my whole thing on this entire stupid copyright thing, we all know it's dumb. We know it's hard. I'm sorry you have to go through all of this. I don't know how it feels. I don't, because I'm just a small YouTuber. But at the end of the day, I still understand that this is a possible thing that could be fought. It's not the end of the world, and I promise you that if you sign any type of paper that they say saying, yes, I would like to dispute, if you put up the fight and the effort, it will work out in your favor, especially with the bigger YouTubers, because you have the influence, you have the pull, you have the necessary resources to make the necessary gains and changes in order to get your videos back on track. So do I fall into that same stupid idiocracy that people are saying that gaming on YouTube is dead? Absolutely not. I think that's ludicrous and it's going way too far. Does it bring you at a slight disadvantage and does it make things a little bit difficult for you? Yes, absolutely. But is it something that you can overcome? Absolutely. I think you're blowing things out of proportion, and I wish people would take things a little bit more seriously and take things a little bit more adult-like, rather than going to Twitter and saying, blah, 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 my channel's gonna die. I guess I'll just become a streamer. That doesn't make sense in my mind. Honestly, it doesn't. If you love what you do, you're gonna fight for it no matter what, tooth and nail. If that is your pride and joy, if that is your child, you will do anything to protect it and anything to keep it going. So my advice to you guys is to pipe the fuck down, get to work, pull all your resources together, and I promise you, your channels are going to be okay, because at the end of the day, it's not about what you put on your channel or how much money your videos make. It's about the people who come, the people who enable you to keep making these videos. And I think that's what people need to remember the most, that money should not play a factor. It's all about passion and how much you want it, how bad you want it. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm sorry this has turned into like a mega rant. Some of you guys don't agree, and I want to kind of expand on this. I'm always open to debates. I love them. I definitely want to talk more. If you're a bigger YouTuber, please shed some more light. I'm not hating on you guys. I'm not at all. I'm really pulling for you guys to please just keep working towards a better YouTube. Not this false pretenses that people can come here and they can just make tons of money, but something that becomes fun and exciting and something that brings people together. A real sense of community, because I feel like we kind of lost that somewhere in translation. A 2009 to 2010 YouTube, that's what we need back right then and there. But anyways, guys, as always, I hope you enjoy the commentary. If you have any questions or you want to start a discussion, please start it in the comment section below. I will be watching this video like a hawk. I desperately want to hear from the community. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoy the gameplay. Please don't forget to check out David's channel if you really enjoyed. And that's pretty much it. But anyways, guys, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I'm Mags. Peace.